These are the major flaws in this argument. Most importantly, there is no direct correlation between the taxes paid and subsidies received. The numbers 40%, 10%, they don't practically mean anything because technically or practically, the taxes paid and subsidies have no direct relationship. The taxes paid help in several other ways. So, manufacturing industry is doing well. It is rich. It pays taxes. The taxes are used by government for various ways, such as building infrastructure, assets on which the success of manufacturing sector may often depend. The argument that manufacturing industry is a major employment generator and therefore it must get greater subsidies is quite flawed. Once again, generation of employment and achieving or receiving subsidies, there is no direct correlation. The argument that the manufacturing industry is a main force behind establishing the nation as a major global economic power does not build a case for deserving greater subsidies. Once again, if something is helping you become a greater economic power, it does not mean that you will start giving subsidies to that particular entity. For example, if Microsoft is giving a lot of tax revenue, international currency to the US government, it does not mean that US government will start giving subsidy to Microsoft. This logic does not hold. The subsidies must be for the needy. The government indirectly helps the manufacturing sector by strengthening the consumers. So by investing in the better education, better infrastructure, better facilities for the consumers, in one word, by strengthening the consumers, the government is helping the manufacturing industry. The government need not give subsidies to an already rich sector. The unfair notion is only emotional, to say the least. This is an argument and things need to be logical, and the logic part is completely missing. There is no data suggesting that manufacturing companies would do better if they were given some sort of subsidies. The entire argument is built on a very, to an extent, amateur premise suggesting that if something is benefiting the government must return subsidies. That is not a mature thought process to have. So these were the main flaws, not too many this time. There are around 5 flaws in this argument. Again, a good structure would be to have a clear introduction. In the introduction, clarify that you are not convinced by the reasoning given in the argument. Then if you have found out 5 flaws, have 5 paragraphs. One paragraph should talk about only one flaw and then have a clear conclusion. The structure of the essay is very important and this particular approach will keep the structure intact. So have an introduction, one flaw per paragraph, and then a clear conclusion suggesting that on the basis of aforesaid analysis, the author's conclusion is not convincing. That will be all.